Hello everyone, welcome back to Kiran's English Shop. So we're continuing with the summaries of 9th class English, and in this video we shall go through Unit 4, Reading B. And as we know that this unit's theme is environment, we also are going to read about the river. Okay, so that might be very much interesting because we all love water, we all love rivers. Okay, yeah, shall go through, yeah. You can see the picture here, a beautiful picture, a painting. Okay, so this is composed by Sables, and here Sables composed this poem River, you know, speaking about the river qualities. Okay, how it is, how is, you know, it passing, how is it moving, okay, where it is ending, okay, what are its features, and everything is given in this poem. Okay, so without wasting any time, I shall quickly move to the poem here. Yeah, see here. So the title is The River. Yeah, river, river, little river. Okay, so river, river, little river. Okay, a small river. Bright you sparkle on your way. Okay, so how are you on your way? You are shining very brightly, sparkle in the sense, you know, no, like shining and all. So you are shining like anything, shining very brightly when you are on your way. On your way in the sense when it is just passing. So if you just look at the river, okay, so the sunshine will be reflecting on your face. Okay, next. This word here, over, okay, O-V-E-R, okay, that is shortcut is O apostrophe of E-R. Over the yellow pebbles dancing. Okay, so how it is again going? It is just like dancing over the yellow pebbles. Okay, pebbles in the, here in the sense you can go with the different stones and all. Okay, so usually water, you know, like it flows above the stones and it passes, right? So the poet here is telling that the river is passing just like a dancing over the yellow pebbles. Through the flowers and foliage glancing, okay? So it is also going through where? Through the flowers and foliage also. Foliage in the sense? Foliage in the sense? Leaves, okay? Glancing in the sense? Just like looking at something continuously, okay? So imagine how the river will pass. For example, if there are flowers, it passes through flowers, passes through leaves, and still the leaves will be staying like that only, okay? So here, the leaves which stay like that, though the water flows through that leaves and all, so that shows here as glancing. Glancing in the sense, just like, you know, seeing like that with a brief look, okay, like that. And next, like a child at play. Okay, how is it growing? Like a child who usually plays. Okay, so when the child is playing, you can see just like a bright sparkle, bright smile on his face. And also, he will not care of any rocks or any pebbles, okay? He will just, you know, go and play wherever he wants. And also, he will just go through the fields. He will go through the trees and he plays, okay? So, here, the poet is comparing a river to the child, okay? Little child game. Next. River, river, swelling river. Okay, so first, in the first place it is little river, the second place it is swelling river. Swelling in the sense, swelling in the sense, okay, you all know swelling, no? If you get any hurt on your skin, it swells, okay, it becomes like a fat place, okay, in that place, okay, in Telugu you'll call it as ubbadam. Okay, so it is just like swelling river. Why is it called as the swelling river by this poet? Because just imagine, for example, our river Ganga is there. Just Ganga river birthplace is somewhere in the north, in the Himalayas, okay? So if you go and see there, it is the birthplace of Ganga is only little small, it is just like small pond like that. But here, when you just see at the edges of the Ganga river, after passing two to three states, you see it will be very big one. So it is just like swelling. From there to here, it is just like swelling. Okay, not smelling, swelling. Next. On you rush through rough and smooth. You are also rushing through rough and smooth soil. If it is rough soil also, you are going through that. If it is smooth soil also, you are going through that soil. Next, louder, faster, brawling, leaping. You are going so much louder. You are also going so much faster. You are also brawling. Brawling in the sense, struggling. Okay. So, here and there, bending that side, this side, up, down, smooth stones, okay, hard ground and all, okay, shouting, just like louder, louder, like louder, shy, okay, shout and all. Just imagine the sound of the river when it makes a sound, okay, you just imagine the sound of the waterfall, okay, just like that. And also, so brawling in the sense like struggling, okay, because, you know, it doesn't go in a straight way. It just, you know, passes just like a snake, okay, here and there, here and there, here and there. So it is just like struggling and leaping. Okay, you all know, no, frog leaping, okay, leaping from one place to another, just like, you know, overflowing from one place to another. So the river has all these qualities, okay. Next, over rocks by rose banks sweeping, over rocks, okay, if there are rocks also. The water flows over the rocks and also by rose banks, okay, rose banks in the sense, not more money banks, okay, bank in the sense the shore, okay, river, shore will be there, no, the edge of the river, okay, all the place that is there with the mud, that is called as the bank. So if there are roses also, the river passes by the all those banks of the roses and all. Sweeping, okay, sweeping in the sense it covers every place that is there on its way. Next, like impetuous youth, okay, impetuous youth in the sense, you know, youth and like children, you usually make quick decisions like that without thinking and anything. Okay, here also river doesn't even wait for anyone. It just goes through over rocks, over, you know, rose banks, okay, rose banks here indicates smoothness and the rocks here indicate hard ground. Okay, if it is hard, if it is smooth, whatever the condition it might be, just keeps on going and going like impetuous youth. Okay, next, river brimming river. Okay, brimming in the sense like full of, okay, with a lot of water and all. Next, broad and deep and still as time. Okay, broad in the sense very much big river and a deep river and still as time. Okay, still as time in a sense, though the time passes, it just stays like that. Next, seeming still yet in motion. Steaming still in a sense, seeming in a sense, just appears to be, okay, just like appears to be, the water in the river appears to be like not moving anywhere, but still it is in the motion in the sense moving only. Few people might underestimate the water that is flowing and they jump into the water, but when the person jumps into that, he experiences that force of the water. Okay, so river seems to be you know, flowing or not moving anywhere, but it moves very fast. Next, tending onwards to the ocean. Tending in the sense just like going towards something, and here the river goes towards the ocean. All the rivers of India, they are born in the western side of, almost western side of or northwest side of the our country, and they flow towards the east side and finally they merge into the seas. Okay, tending towards the ocean in the sense seas. Okay, seas. So these rivers, they pass like this into the seas finally. Next, like a, just like immortal prime. Okay, immortal prime in the sense, you know, that is the best part of its life. Okay, the part which it has for that time, just like going here there before entering into the ocean, whatever the time it has, that is very much precious. Okay, very much immortal and very much, you know, the part of one's life which cannot come back. Okay, so all the life it has, you know, flowing from one place to another, that time will not come back again. Okay, so once the river finally merges into the water, the same water cannot flow back from the back again. Okay, so that is just like a memorable, a mortal prime. Next, river, headlong river, headlong in the sense like a snake. Imagine snake, it has head at one place and tail at one place. It doesn't know where it tails or tail starts also, where is tail also. Okay, so just like it has a long tail, long body, and head is in one place and the tail is in one place, we do not know. So it is very long. Down you dash into the sea. Okay, when you dash into the sea, okay, finally you are going to merge into the sea. Dash in the sense, not like hitting someone, of course it is just like hitting someone, but here the river finally merges. Okay, merges into the sea. See that line hath never sounded. Hath in the sense has. Here hath is old English word. Okay, in the two verses here we have hath, actually that is has. Okay, see that line has never sounded. Usually see, their lines are, okay, lines in the sense their edges. Okay, edges are never estimated. Okay, sounded in the sense recorded here. Okay, the seas which lines are never recorded, never written, never estimated, and see that sail hath never rounded, and seas on which nobody has sailed in the sense traveled. Okay, all round the globe. Okay, so on the sea, there is no person who has traveled all the seas on the globe. Okay, so the seas are the seas which are very much rounded, and on the all seas there is no person who has sailed on them. Okay, next, like eternity. Okay, eternity in the sense like everlasting, which has no death. Okay, so finally when this river, which has so much beautiful qualities, when it finally merges into the sea, it doesn't come back, of course, but it has just like eternal life. Okay, it will not die. Okay, it has never ending life in the future. Okay, so it is very beautiful here, and it is composed by C.A. Bowles. Next, we can see a little bit of C.A. Bowles here. So her full name is Caroline Ann Bowles, born in 1786 and died in 1854, was married to Robert Southey, who was the poet laureate of Britain. So she wrote various other books, including Chapter on Churchyard and the Tales of the Factories. Yeah, here we have some glossary. First one, sparkle in the sense reflect or shine. Okay, reflecting back. Next, foliage, leaves, glancing, taking a brief look, swelling, increasing or expanding in size. Next, brawling, struggling, rose banks, river banks where roses appear along. Okay, next, impetus, rash, or acting quickly without thinking. Next, brimming, full of, trending, going in a particular way. Mortal prime, the best part of one's life that cannot last forever. Next, headlong, with the head first and the rest of the body following back. Following in the sense backside. Next, hath, has. Hath is Old English. There are few more Old English words which are still used by the present poets in their poems. Okay, next, eternity, life continuing without end, even after death. Okay, we call them eternal soul, eternal people in a sense, who doesn't have death like that. Okay, so such a sweet poem about the river here with the theme environment. And in the next video, we shall go through reading C, that is Can't Climb Trees Anymore. Okay, so before leaving the video, do not forget to subscribe so that you will get the notifications when I upload the next videos. And if you want to watch all the other videos, you can go through the playlist of my channel. And there you will find all the videos from class 6 to 9, 10th. Okay, most of the viewers are
commenting me back, asking for the videos of the next readings, like B, C, some of them A, okay? So do not worry, all the videos are placed in the order in the playlists, okay? So visit my playlist, so there you will find all the videos, no need to worry. So see you all in the next video. God bless you, take care.